advances in core signaling technology to handle millions of connected devices, the agility to add new services and create and manage customized network slices, and the continuous optimization of network resources to control cost. There are three other drivers worth mentioning. The 5G standalone core is programmable, allowing enterprises to create applications for particular segments like healthcare or communities like students. The 5G network is a platform exposing APIs for the creation of new applications. The openness to third-party developers also allows experts in particular industries to create what's needed. This is similar to the ecosystem of developers that exist for other software platforms. 5G was developed in parallel with the increased maturity of the cloud. The result is that 5G core software is created with cloud-first thinking. Cloud-native design principles already used in web-scale and IT applications are now used in the 5G core software. Service-based architectures and microservice implementations mean better scaling, easier upgrade to new versions, and flexibility to extend the core with new functionality. DevOps means that lifecycle operations are automated, reducing human involvement in repetitive tasks. Cloud agnostic means that the software can run on any cloud infrastructure, either locally or in one of the public clouds. And one more, the 5G core is designed to work with service orchestrators and network assurance software. Extreme automation of network operations is needed to create and assure the right network performance for the millions of users, peoples, devices, slices. Network orchestrators and network assurance software are as essential to the 5G SA core as 3GPP signaling. There are some base decisions before a plan can be put in place. There are many paths to get from 4G LTE to 5G standalone. It can be done in one step or through the non-standalone path. All subscribers can be migrated right away, or standalone can be introduced for IoT use cases first. Similarly, there are many paths to the zero-touch automation goal. An aggressive automation plan requires a disruptive reinvention of the workforce and the business processes, whereas a move over several years allows the workforce and processes to learn and to adapt. The cloud selection is also becoming more complex. 5 years ago, the default choice was to build an in-house virtual machine-based cloud. Today's service providers can select from virtual machines or containers, public cloud, private cloud, or a hybrid. Their choice depends on their culture, their subscriber base, their in-house skill sets, and also how they plan to differentiate with 5G in future. Tied to the cloud selection is the design of the security architecture. This isn't new. All networks need to design for security. However, the new cloud models bring new potential threats, and those need to be analyzed and handled. Legislation and standards in this area are changing and also need to be watched and incorporated into the SA design. Once the CSP has made these base architecture decisions, they have to determine how they will get a return on their investment. Some CSPs want to focus on enterprises and mission-critical services, whereas others, the value providers, will use 5G primarily for cost optimization through automation. Some have already built a mature ecosystem of partners who are ready to start developing new services, whereas others see this as a future idea. Every operator has their own business objectives, and these will determine the pace of their move. This is where intelligence is added to automation. We know that the core needs to adapt rapidly to changing user patterns and handle frequent overload conditions. Bandwidth hunger continues. If you look at the network, the core software is layered onto a cloud, which in turn sits on a distributed hardware configuration. In this environment, manual deployments, troubleshooting, and reconfigurations are not just slow, but also error-prone. The 5G SA core has full automation for installation, deployment, and scaling. We are also developing a self-healing core that uses machine learning to identify faults and then heal the network around them.